Random House Audio Roads presents Starfist, Book 9, Lazarus Rising, by David Sherman and Dan Cragg. Read for you by John Bedford Lloyd. Arrogant unbeliever, Lesser Imam Shamar thought as he shivered under dripping fronds, watching Gunnery Sergeant Bass place sensors in the soggy ground. The Marine had ordered Shamar to place his five soldiers as security so he could fiddle with the sensors, but the Lesser Imam had simply dismissed the soldiers farther into the undergrowth, then used the cover provided by the vegetation to spy on the two Marines. The Lesser Imam was tired of taking orders from an off-world gunnery sergeant. What's more, the man was not a proper sword. The off-worlders didn't even have proper titles of rank. In the Lesser Imam's world, a sergeant was somebody who groveled before a judge in the courts. Shamar cast a longing glance at the armored personnel carrier. He wanted to return to it. Inside, it would be warm and dry. There was a brilliant flash, then a wave of searing heat.
"Gunny," DuPont said. "The U-Pud's picking up motion deeper in the trees."
"It's probably the soldiers. They don't have good field discipline."
"I don't think so, Gunny. What I'm picking up is farther into the trees."
Bass grimaced. "I don't trust that damn thing." He was reaching into a cargo pocket for his personal motion detector when it felt like his entire arm was being torn off. Simultaneously, something ripped off his helmet and threw him to the ground. As he lay, dazed, just meters away, he saw two shreds of gore, one lying on the ground, the other hovering above it. They struck him as very curious, in a distracting kind of way. When he managed to focus on them, he saw two ankles sticking out of a pair of chameleon boots. Idly, he wondered if DuPont had blisters on his feet and had taken his boots off to ease the pain. But if DuPont had taken his boots off, why had he left his feet inside them? A sudden, horrible wave of pain washed over Bass, and then he lost consciousness. On board the CNSS Grandar Bay, the Marines of the 34th Fleet Initial Strike Team were anxious to get back to Camp Ellis, their home port on Thorsfini's world. Despite the fact that the Marine Corps rated Thorsfini's world a hardship post. Back in the world called the Kingdom of Yahweh and His Saints and Their Apostles, they'd been surprised to find themselves fighting skinks instead of the peasant revolt they'd expected. The Kingdom campaign had been costly. The first phase was especially brutal. More than 200 Marines had been killed or too badly wounded to return to active duty, mostly from the infantry battalion. Mike Company had suffered the most. More than an entire platoon had been wiped out when the skinks sprang their first ambush in the Swamp of Perdition. That didn't mean other units hadn't suffered severely. Company L's 3rd Platoon had lost PFCs Hayes and Gimbel, Lance Corporals DuPont, Van Impey, Rhoda Moore and Watson, Corporal Stevenson, and Gunnery Sergeant Bass. Gunny Bass. Damn. Corporal Gudanis and Sergeant Bladen were wounded badly enough that they'd been evacuated off-planet. They had survived their wounds, but would they ever return to 3rd Platoon, or even to active duty? Nobody knew. Gunny Bass. There was hardly a man in the entire company who wouldn't have been happy to be in his platoon. And now he was gone. First Acolyte Ben Lohman stood in the observation cupola of his command car and scanned the foothills before him. He had halted his reconnaissance platoon just behind a low ridge and positioned his lead vehicle so he could see over the military crest. An unmanned reconnaissance aircraft had spotted something out there, and he had been sent to investigate. His heart thumped heavily inside his chest out of fear and excitement. Fear that they had at last found some surviving demons, and excitement
that this time they would have the killing edge. The demon host had been defeated, and First Acolyte Ben Lohman's platoon, one of many recon units searching for demon survivors, might today be the first element of the Army of the Lord to make contact with the vile creatures. Ben Lohman was no fool. He knew that the demons at the height of their power were more than a match for anything the Kingdomite army could throw at them. But the off-world Marines had broken the siege of Haven and crushed the demons, who had fled with the Marines in hot pursuit. If any demons were still on Kingdom, they would be demoralized and under-equipped for battle. Ben Lohman was hot for revenge and eager to prove himself in battle as an officer of the Army of the Lord. His headset crackled. "Sir, we await your orders," Senior Sword Rypor announced. Ben Lohman winced at the insistent tone in the Senior Sword's voice, as if the enlisted man were reminding him to get on with his mission. Rypor was a capable but overcautious non-com, always reminding his platoon commander that his mission was to find the enemy, not engage him. Senior Sword Rypor seemed actually afraid they might make contact with the demons. They'd been on patrol for 3 weeks and were some 1,200 kilometers from the capital city of Haven. The main body of the Burning Bush Regiment was positioned 60 kilometers to their rear, eyes, ears, and weapons at the ready. Everyone's nerves were on edge, expecting any moment to run into the enemy, but so far, none had appeared. "Hold your position. I'm coming back there." Ben Lohman threw off his headset with a loud bang that made his driver and gunner look up suddenly. "Take over the surveillance," he curtly told the driver. He grabbed his map unit and climbed out of the cupola. "If you see anything, get on the horn. I'll be back with the Senior Sword." He stepped lightly out of the vehicle and walked quickly back to Senior Sword Rypor's position. The Senior Sword saw him coming and dismounted. "Have you seen them, sir?" "Come over here and I'll show you." Ben Lohman guided the non-com into the scrub about 25 meters from the vehicles. They crouched in the shade of a small tree, and Lohman activated his terrain unit. "It's just like the Colonel Deacon told us back at the CP. A three-dimensional overlay of the foothills 3 kilometers to their front appeared on the screen. The bird spotted infrared signatures in this box canyon here." He zoomed in on the suspected area. The canyon walls were steep and massive, the passage through it narrow and littered with rockfalls.
"Yes, sir."
"The only way in there is on foot," Senior Sword Rypor said. His voice betrayed his anxiety at the thought of so small a force negotiating that narrow space between the canyon walls.
"Well, Swordie, we're going to have to go in there, and that's what we're here for," Ben Lohman responded.
He looked into the Senior Sword's eyes, and after a moment the non-com dropped his gaze to the display on the terrain unit. "He's afraid," Ben Lohman thought.
"Why don't we just call in air or artillery?"
"We are here, and we're going in there." The Senior Sword had a worried expression on his face.
"Sir, I recommend we call for reinforcements from regiment," he said, forcing the words out.
That was standing operational procedure for a reconnaissance unit. Find the enemy and call in the heavy stuff, not engage if a fight could be avoided.
"We will, when I give the word. But I'm not causing the entire regiment to deploy until I know for sure what's up there. If they are demons, they'll be demoralized. And if we have to fight them, we can."
Ben Lohman glanced at the sun, hanging just above the horizon.
"It'll be dark in another hour. We'll go in under the cover of darkness."
Senior Sword Rypor said nothing. They had excellent night optics, thanks to the Marines. But still. "Look, it's probably nothing. Probably wild animals nested up there, or refugees. But if it is the demons, we're alert, heavily armed, and ready for combat. Go back to your vehicle, get some rest, and when it's full dark, we'll go in." Ben Lohman spoke gently. He could not afford to have his senior enlisted man get cold feet now. "We're just going to go up..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.